I don't know what is the relation between making YouTube videos and having bad macro photos. Every time I come here and I want to make a YouTube video about macro photography, I end up with bad photos which I don't like at all. And I will show you these photos right now. These photos, all these photos I made before even starting making YouTube videos, and I like all of them. I don't know what is the relation between making YouTube videos and having bad macro photos. Maybe the main reason, I think, that making macro photos need a lot of patience, and you have to stay calm and you don't have to move from, or you don't have to search to another places. I mean, when you find a good place, and when you find, for example, a place where there's a train, I think, no. And when you find a place there's a lot of insects, for example, or a lot of beautiful flower, you have to stick there and you have to be calm and to be patient and to make photos slowly. But when I want to make YouTube videos, like today, for example, as you have just seen, making YouTube videos needs a lot of B-rolls, different B-rolls, different angles to make the video a little bit more interesting and less boring. And B-rolls, I think, helps by giving you an idea about the surroundings or about the place where I am in. For example, when you see me walking in this direction here, and when you see close-up clips or close-up footage about the flowers or about the leaves here, you have an idea about the place which I am in and what I want to take a photo of. So today, the main reason of being here is that I have the 50mm lens, only the 50mm lens, and I have the reverse ring for this lens, and I want to try to take photos only with that 50mm lens reverse, without any macro lens, without any close-up filters, just the 50mm lens reverse. And I want to try to search for any simple, very simple photo, beautiful photo, interesting photo. And if you are asking yourself why I'm using the 50mm lens normally with the CBL filter, I was using it for making the B-roll, because there's a lot of light reflections on the leaves, and I found that using a CBL filter to make B-roll is better than having a lot of white light on the leaves. As you have just seen, I was taking a lot of photos, and as you can see, I am releasing the head of the tripod, because if I want to make it like that, and it's very hard, it's not even possible to go back and forth when you want to use the tripod like this. So that's why I was releasing the head of the tripod, and I was using two legs of the tripod to make it so steady like that, and I was coming back and forth. So I can, by doing that, I can reduce the handshake. There's no handshake at all, because two legs of the tripod is on the ground, and at the same time I am free to go back and forth and to put the thing that I want to be in focus freely without any problem. So my setting, I'm using the manual mode, obviously, because if you want to use any other mode when you are reversing your lens, the camera won't be able to take photos, because it can't see that there's a lens attached to the body of the camera. So, and I'm using 1/40 of the second ISO 250 to have a little bit faster shutter speed. And the f-stop, I was trying to use between f8 and something like between f4 and f8 to have more things in sharp, because I can't make any focus stack today. It's so, as you can see, it's so windy, and I'm sure I will not be able to make any focus stack when the flower is moving a lot. The main problem of using this lens, I think I did mention that before, but I will say it again today, is that this lens, the 1.8D and not G, when you reverse this lens, the focus ring doesn't play any role and doesn't change the focus. And that's why the only main way, or the only way to focus, is to go back and forth from the subject. From the subject itself. For example, if I want to be a little bit far from the flower, it will be out of focus and I can't change that. And if I want to be closer to the flower a little bit, it will also be out of focus, and I can't change that because the focus ring doesn't play any role, and I have to stick in the same exact distance from the flower, and that's why I can't play with the composition. I want to try to take a photo if there's very small leaves coming from exactly from the ground, so I will try to put the camera exactly on the ground. I think without a tripod I will put the camera on the ground, it will be steady, and I will try to take the photo eye level of these small leaves. And I'm not sure I will take it with the reverse lens, I will try the both ways because they are a little bit big, so maybe I will need to be a little bit far away. I will use the 50 millimeter lens normally and without reversing it. So if you are new to this channel and you haven't seen my old macro videos, I will put a playlist here to the old videos. So as you have just seen today, if you really like macro photography, if you want to take macro photos but you are not making that because you are waiting to have a macro lens, you really don't have to have macro lens. If you have a 50 millimeter lens, 1800 5 millimeter lens, 1855 millimeter lens, any lens, you can get a reverse ring and you can attach it to the lens, reverse this lens, and you can use it in a very easy way, and you can start taking macro photos. At least, I mean, you can start, but after that, if you feel that you want something more than that, and you can get a macro lens, but I mean, at least at the beginning, you can start right now with making macro photos with any lens you have. Just get a reverse ring, and after that, you can reverse the lens and you can start experiencing with macro photography. So thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you liked the photos. Please consider subscribing if you are not already, and see you in the next video. Bye.